This video will investigate the separation of electric charge and how it leads to lightning strikes on Earth and other planets in our solar system. There are several important facts regarding electric charge that are easy to demonstrate. First, there are two kinds of electric charge, known as positive and negative. Second, like charges repel and opposite charges attract. We can easily demonstrate these principles by charging different rods of material by rubbing them. Note that these materials are insulators, meaning that charge will not move on them. All of us are familiar with charging by rubbing, be it walking across shag carpeting, making a balloon stick to a wall, or removing clothes from the dryer. We will use a clear rod of acrylic and a dark rod of PVC. I can charge these rods simply by rubbing them with paper towels. A third smaller rod is half acrylic and half PVC and can spin about its mounted center. I begin by charging both halves of the smaller rods. Note that when I rub the acrylic rod, it attracts the PVC rod and repels the acrylic rod. If I rub the PVC rod, it attracts the acrylic rod and repels the PVC rod. By rubbing the rods with paper, the acrylic becomes positively charged and the PVC negatively charged. This behavior is due to the underlying structure of matter. Positively charged protons are found in the nucleus of atoms, along with neutrons that have no charge, while negatively charged electrons orbit around the nucleus. The attraction between the oppositely charged protons and electrons holds the electrons in orbit, much like the force of gravity holds planets in orbit around the sun. The electric force is described mathematically by Coulomb's law and is proportional to the magnitude of the two charges involved and inversely proportional to the square of their separation. Most matter is electrically neutral, meaning that there is just as much positive charge as negative charge. An object is said to be charged when there is more of one type than the other. Rubbing objects together often allows separation of charge to occur as materials hang on to their electrons with varying strengths. Rubbed objects become charged as one material steals electrons from the other. When rubbing acrylic with paper, the acrylic becomes positively charged as the paper takes electrons from the acrylic. This aluminum can is electrically neutral, having the same large number of positive and negative charges. Note that aluminum is a conductor, so that charges can move around. So if we charge up the PVC rod and bring the negatively charged rod near the can, it causes the charges in the can to separate, attracting the positive charges to the near side and repelling the negative charges to the far side. The positive charges are closer, and the rod attracts the can. Let's look at a standard question over this material commonly used in introductory physics classes. An uncharged metal sphere sits on a tabletop. A negatively charged PVC rod is brought close by, but not touching. Which image below correctly represents the resulting charge on the sphere? Your instructor will now stop the video, allowing you to make a prediction. Make sure that you explain your reasoning for making the choice that you did. Note that the charges can move on the metal sphere because it is a conductor, and that the negatively charged rod will cause the charges on the metal sphere to redistribute themselves, with like charges repelling each other and opposites attracting each other. Lightning is due to the separation of charge by rubbing, but note that the details of charge separation in clouds is not well understood. It is hard to get up into a thundercloud to do research. Lightning is an electrical discharge that can occur between clouds and from cloud to ground. The substances involved in charge separation are thought to be liquid water and semi-frozen water known as grapple. Thunderstorms have considerable air turbulence. Conditions for lightning are thought to be produced when updrafts carrying water and downdrafts carrying grapple interact. Electrons are sheared off the upward moving water and carried downward by the grapple. Since the cloud is mainly air, an insulator, over time there is a tremendous buildup of positive charge at the top of the cloud and negative charge at the bottom, which attracts positive charge on the ground. Eventually, a rush of charge occurs, both positive and negative charges moving toward each other that we see as lightning. Optical flashes thought to be lightning have been observed on other planets. This image was taken by Voyager 1 in 1979, looking at the dark side of Jupiter. The blue arc near the top is an aurora. The bright flashes in the middle and bottom are thought to be lightning. This image shows lightning on the daytime side of Saturn, observed by the Cassini probe. In addition to these observations, radio signals consistent with those produced by lightning have been received from Venus and all of the Jovian planets. These signals are brief bursts of static across many frequencies. The presence of lightning on these planets suggests that there are strong vertical currents in their atmospheres, separating charge. More teaching materials can be found on the web at astro.unl.edu.